We made it, y'all. It's Friday. Let's go.
Spit it to the rhythm of the piano, so now I gotta get a drummer some. Put the T up on the track, I'll be phenomenal, cause when it come to having a hit, I'ma make another one. Blink 182 times, when you see the twister with Travis, madness, kinda like a savage.
Yes, yes, it is Friday. I've been waiting for this day all week. This is Antoine, a.k.a. the Bigfella, by the way. It is 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Didn't have any calls today, but that's because I busted my butt all this week and cleared out all of my calls. I think I did like maybe 20 some calls this week, and I got it all cleared up, so I didn't have anything to do today. Been sitting at home relaxing, you know, recovering and all that good stuff, and you know, just trying to get ready for this weekend. I honestly don't know what's going on. The plans keep changing, but I'm pretty sure I am actually going to go fishing. I have a company meeting on Monday, and it's supposed to be a company picnic on Sunday, but I'm not sure if I'm going to go or not because I want to spend some more time with my family. But yeah, let's go ahead and get this weekend vlog started. Hope you guys enjoy. All right, you guys, I came up here to town to meet my wife to get an oil change on the truck. Right now, we're just browsing around, getting some stuff and looking at some other stuff. They actually already have the Christmas stuff up, so I guess we need to start looking at that kind of stuff, too. All right, you guys, we made it home and checked the mailbox, and the Lucky Tackle box was in there. And they've dedicated this one to Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and I love, love, love this box. I had a family member that passed away not too long ago from breast cancer, so I really, really like this box. All right, you guys, now I'm in the grocery store making a ice cream run. Got a little bit of a sweet tooth tonight. But that seems to happen a lot on Friday nights. Is my sweet tooth just kicks into overdrive, and I just need ice cream or something like that. But let me go ahead and pay for this, and then I'm going outside and watch all the bikes go by because it's bike week down here in the beach area. Well, all the motorcycles that were in the parking lot are now gone. I thought I heard them revving up a little while ago when I was in the store. I guess they all decided to leave. I know there's a bar in town. They're going to be doing live music all weekend, so they're probably heading over there to get their party on and whatnot. But I'm pretty sure I'll be hearing them, you know, riding back and forth in front of my house all weekend long, so I'll probably catch some bikes for y'all. Good morning, y'all. It is 10:45. I am currently sitting in the parking lot of the hardware store. I'm getting ready to get the wood to replace the flooring in the boat. I actually bought the boat with me. Want to have them cut it to the length I need, and we're just going to drop it in the boat, and I'm going to take it home that way. But I'm going to try to get that done today, so I'll be able to have a flooring when I go fishing tomorrow. And should be a pretty fun project, and that brings us one step closer to the end of phase one of this boat build. Well, y'all, got it, but I forgot screws, so I got to run back in here and get some screws. Wait, that's not all, it's just a bunch of cars in the way. Alright, y'all, we're about to cut this to measurement and get this floor put in here. I'm excited. All right, y'all, after some cutting, some grinding, some more grinding, some more cutting, and some more grinding, we got the floor in there. As you can see, it's like dark 30 out here, so we're still plugging away at it. We probably want to get this live wall dropped in, and that'll be that for the night. All right, you guys, I made the initial cut for the cooler. I just got to, you know, fit it and measure it and get the cooler down in here, and I can go ahead and start putting some screws in here. I'm almost done. I'm kind of excited. I can't wait to take this boat out tomorrow now.
Yes, Lord, for another day, I just think of my girl. Yeah, that's my girl in the past in the sea. Windows down, dancing around, causing the scene. That's my girl, sipping Crown and Sprite. In a ball cap, turn back, who is she right? Me like, yeah, baby girl, you gonna do it again. Drinking all the grand vision, you were with them. But I bet they don't see what I see when I see my girl.
All right, y'all, we got the Livewell in, and it's a pretty snug fit on both sides. So snug that I lifted the floor, but I can just throw some screws in there. But we're close. Well, y'all, she's finalized. She's all screwed in and finished up.
Finito.
I'm taking this bad boy fishing tomorrow. I might even use the Livewell. Alright, you guys, I got the boat hooked up to get ready to take out tomorrow. Floor is looking good, feeling good. Livewell's in, back floor. And that's pretty much phase one, just getting that floor done. Phase two will be the deck on the front, and then phase three will be the upholstery, like the new carpet, the paint. And I'll probably include that bow mount trolling motor in that today as well, because that's like $400 or $500, the one I want. So I'm got to save up some money for that. But need to go in here and shower, because I am filthy. I mean, look at me. My shirt's wet. I'm covered in sawdust. And been sweating. It's like 80 degrees. It's pretty hot out here today. I don't know what's going on with the weather. But next week is going to be like in the 70s. So I don't know. The weather's still fluctuating here in Virginia. Hope the fishing is pretty good tomorrow. Brother-in-law went today. They said they didn't catch anything but like a little bass. So we'll see how it goes. All right, you guys, I just got out the shower, and I'll tell you one thing. That shower was life. I feel great now. I'm about to go downstairs to get some food because I am starving. Like, Eric showed up, and he ate dinner. I was too excited that he was here because he was going to help me with the boat. So I didn't eat dinner. Here it is, 10:07 at night. And I was wondering why my stomach was touching my backbone. I'm so hungry. So I'm about to go downstairs and get some food and replenish myself. All right, you guys, it's 7 in the morning. About to head out now, just loaded the boat and all that good stuff. Pretty warm out here, and it looked like it actually rained, and it looks like it's going to rain again, so I need to grab me a rain jacket. But I'm hoping it's going to be a good day of fishing. I really do. All right, y'all, I'm out here on the lake. Bit of a mishap here. The mount to my camera that goes on my chest mount broke. I have another mount at home, of course, so I won't be filming on this today. So if I catch anything, it'll be on this camera here. So let's go ahead and start fishing. Right now I have tied on a bluegill waffle plopper, a black and blue chatterbait, that frog, and what else did I have to, oh, a jig, minnow jig to be more precise. Probably flipping and pitching some of those laydowns when I get up there to them. But without further ado, let me go ahead and start fishing. I got one with the waffle plopper, you guys. He's fish slime in the face. Probably about maybe a couple pounds or so. I'm thinking about keeping fish today. I don't think I'm going to keep this one. He's a little on the small side. So I'm going to go ahead and get him released. But definitely a nice little fish. You know, I was sitting here thinking, I got the Livewell running for a reason, so I went ahead and threw the fish in there, and I'll probably still release them, but I'll do it on the boat ramp when I get back, because I kind of want to take some more pictures with them, just in case. That's the only fish I catch today. Tell you what, I could have sat back in that corner all day long. I just kept getting hit after hit. Just couldn't get the hook set in anything, especially on that frog and the lily pads today for some reason. They just either hit it and can't get the hook set, or they just miss it completely. But right now it's starting to drizzle just a little bit. Not that that's going to bother me, but happened to look down at my feet and notice that the boat has some water in it, more than what I'm used to seeing. So I need to get that checked out here pretty soon. So here, take a look at the water. Yeah, see, there's quite a bit of water coming in, so I need to check the bottom of this boat to make sure I didn't drill any holes in anything. I mean, it'll take a while for the boat to sink because all that's filled with foam on both sides, so I can still fish on my way out of here, but I think I'm going to go ahead and get off of the water so I can take a look and see if I punctured the bottom of this boat at all, or it might be the plug, who knows. As you can see, the rain has picked up quite a bit. I'm still going to fish. I got my rain jacket in case it does get super duper heavy, but this isn't bothering me at all right now. Do y'all see that right there? That's a dead deer carcass. Like, I don't know if it fell down in the water and drowned and, you know, fish just picked at it over time, but yeah, that's a dead deer. Wow. Well, I knew I was bound to hook one sooner or later. Got me a pickerel here. Right here next to the boat ramp, fishing over here with the lily pad, by the lily pads with this whopper popper. But let me get him off here, and I think I'm going to go ahead and start heading in. All right, you guys, I got the boat. I'm back on the trailer. I'm just checking the lights now to make sure the turn signals and all that stuff work. Looks like they are. But great day of fishing. I got one bass in the boat, one pickerel, and had a bunch of missed opportunities. I just couldn't get the hook set in anything, or they just kept missing it all together. I really wish I had it on film, because it was definitely nothing but top water all day today. But get ready to head back home. Going to say bye to Lake Travis for now until next time. So I'll see you guys when I get back to the house.
Hey, country girl, this country boy, like everything but pop. Don't change a thing, no way, you stay the same, I got you. I like soul all that, head to toe, you all that. Tell old boy he call back, send a text, they fall back. Cause I can see you got a thing for the fast life. So come on, shorty, let me show you what the fast life. Whipping across the border, Florida into Georgia. Cause baby, you a song and you make me wanna roll my windows down. Down a back road, blowing stop signs through the middle, every hood, every town. With you and this drop top Chevy painted real.
Alright, here y'all go. Better picture. There we go. Thumbnail. Cheese. Alright, you guys, I'm home. I stopped at my parents' house first. I wanted to give that fish to my dad because he really loves fresh fish. Don't get me wrong, I love fresh fish too. I just didn't have time to clean it and eat it today or eat it in the next couple days. I have a company meeting at 8 o'clock in the morning, and it's a 2.5 hour drive, so I'm going to stay in a hotel up that way tonight. So I need to get packed and get ready for that and all that good stuff. Plus, we're redoing company photos, so I need to, you know, shape this up a little bit, and so I can look nice for the picture. But I want to remind you guys, the MTB LTB contest is still going on, so find the video, or I'll just link it at the end of the video here. You know, click on that, watch it, and follow the directions to enter that contest. I got the lucky tackle box already, so the mystery tackle box should be here any day now. I'll do the unboxing and the contest winner announcement right around the 15th of the month. I should have the other box by then, and that'll also give you guys a little more time to enter if you haven't entered already. But I think that's all I have for you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed the boat build and all that good stuff this weekend and all our little foolish antics and whatnot while doing so. But that's going to do it for this episode of Bigfella Outdoors. Be sure to tune into the next episode where you can catch me outside doing what I love most, getting my dose of the great outdoors. Be sure to get yours too. Y'all have a great week.
He said, I went skydiving, I went Rocky Mountain climbing, I went 2.7 seconds on a bull named Fu Manchu. And I looked deeper and I spoke sweeter and I gave forgiveness I've been denying. said, someday I hope you get the chance to live like you were dying. He said, I was finally the husband, but most of the time I wasn't. I became a friend would like to have. And all of a sudden going fishing wasn't such an imposition. And I went 3 times that year.